Hi everyone, hope you are fine. So today we'll take up one more problem on LPP and we'll solve that by using Simplex method. I have already uploaded one video on this, please watch that video. Now today we are going to discuss about this problem. We are going to find out MaxZ value of this LPP by using Simplex method. So as we know, the first step here is we are going to convert all these inequalities into equalities by adding slack variable to all these functions here, all these equations that we have here. So what we are going to do first, we are going to convert all inequality into equality. Fine, so we'll write here MaxZ is equal to x1 plus x2 plus 3x2, and then we are going to convert all inequalities into equalities. Fine, so we are going to write here 3x1 plus 2x2 plus x3 plus s1 is equal to 3. Then we are going to write down next one, 2x1 plus x2 plus 2x3 is equal to 2. Then we have all these here, these variables, we are going to copy and paste it here and add s1 and s2. So all are greater than or equal to 0. These have to be greater than or equal to 0. Fine. So this is the first step that we have to do. What is the first step? The first step is we have to convert all inequalities into equalities. Fine. So here we are going to add s2. Fine. So here we have now 3x1 plus 2x2 plus x3 plus s1 is equal to 3. Then 2x1 plus x2 plus 2x3 plus s2 is equal to 2. Then x1, x2. x3, s1 and s2 all are greater than or equal to 0, and here we are going to add these variables with 0 as their coefficient plus 0 as 2. Fine, so this is what we have here. Fine, so after that the next step is we are going to make our iteration tables here. So here we are going to write down the first one is CJ. Fine, then we have here next one is basis. Fine, then we have here CB values. Now if we see here the variables that we have here is x1, then we have x2, then we have x3, then we have s1, then we have s2. Fine, and then we have here bi value, and then we have here theta values. Fine, so this is the first table that we have here. Fine, now the bases here are, for the first one is s1. Fine, the first one is s1, and then we have s2. Now the coefficient of, that is the coefficient of this, is s1 0, s2 is again 0. Now if we talk about the coefficient of these bases here, we have x1. What is the coefficient of x1 here? If we go here, it is x1, it has 1 coefficient. Then x2 has again 1. Then x3 has 3. The coefficient of x3 is 3, and s1 and s2 have 0 coefficients. Fine, now we are going to find out from these two equations the coefficient values of all these respective variables. X1 has 3, right? If you go here, x1 has 3, then x2 has 2 variable here, 2 coefficient here, then x3 has 1, then s1 has 1 here, s1 has 1 and s2 is 0, and then bi value is 3. Now if we go to here, if we see what is the value of this coefficient value, it is 2. Then x2 has 1, then x3 has 2, then s1 is not there, so the coefficient is 0, and s1 is there, and hence 1, and the bi value is 2. Fine. After that, we have to find out zj value. What is the zj value? The zj value is the evaluation here. Then we are going to find out zj minus cj values. Fine. So this is what we are going to find here. How do we calculate this zj value? We are going to multiply this cb coefficient with this, plus this 0 with this 2. Now if we multiply them and add them, as the coefficient is here, both are 0, both these coefficients are 0, so if we multiply here with any number, it will become 0 only. Fine. Here also it is 0. Here also, how much it is? It is again 0, and here it is again 0, here again 0. Fine. So now zj minus cj, so this is this minus this, it will be how much? Minus 1. Fine. This would be equal to again minus 1. Fine. Then it is minus 3, then it is 0, and then this one is again 0. Now we have to find out the most least negative value here, and the most least negative value, now value is here this minus 3. As we see, all these zj minus cj values are these are negative values, and hence we say the solution is not optimal here, because if we want the solution to be optimal, all zj minus cj value should be greater than or equal to 0. But we can see here, we have two zeros here, two zero values, but rest all are negative, and hence the solution is not optimal. So what we are going to do, we are going to take the least negative value here of this zj minus cj, which is minus 3, this value. Fine. This value. Now what we are going to do with this column, this is going to enter now. This is going to enter now, and one has to exit. If this is entering, one has to exit. Now which one has to exit, we are going to decide that based on the value of theta values. Fine. So the least theta value will exit. The least theta value will exit. So how are we going to calculate the theta values? It is equal to bi value, this divided by the respective numbers of this column, which is exiting. Now 3 divided by 1 is how much? 3 divided by 1 is 3. Fine. And 2 divided by 2 is what? 2 divided by 2 is 1. And hence the least negative, least the lowest value here from the theta values is 1, and hence this is going to exit. This is going to exit. Fine. So this one will exit now. Now see here, if S2 is exiting and X3 is entering, these two, I mean this column and this row, wherever they intersect, that intersecting point or intersecting cell becomes the key element or the key factor. It becomes key factor here. So this 2 is the key, this key 2 is the key factor here. Fine. Now see here, we are going to again take the same values here. So we'll start with cj value, cj, then basis b, basis value, and then we have here cb values, we have here cb values. Now again we are going here, we have what? We have x1. Fine. We have x2. Fine. We have x3. Fine. S2 is exiting here. If S2 is exiting, there is no need to take it. So hence we are going to take only that is S1, and then after S1 we have bi value, and then we have theta values. Fine. After that, the basis here is S1 will remain S1 only. Fine. But in place of S2, X3 is entering. X3 is entering. Now the coefficient, we have to find the coefficient values here also. The coefficient values here for S1 is 0, and for X3 it is 3. Fine. So for this one it is 3. It is 3. Fine. Now as this is the row which is entering, and hence we are going to calculate this row first. So how are we going to calculate this row? This row we are going to calculate from this one, from this one. How? We are going to take these values and divide by the key factor. What is the key factor here? The key factor here is 2. So all these values we are going to take, respective values, and we are going to divide it by 2. Now here the first one is 2. The first one is 2. 2 divided by 2 is how much? 2 divided by 2 is 1. Then we have here this 1. 1 divided by 2 is what? It is 1 by 2. It is 1 divided by 2. Fine. One divided by 2 is 1 by 2. Then we have 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. Now see here, we have S1 value. S1 value is 0. 0 here. 0. 0 divided by 2 is how much? 0 divided by 2 is, it is 0. And then BI value would be how much? It will be 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1. Fine. Now we have this one, that is this row we have to calculate, that is new first row. If we want to calculate this new first row, what is the rule for this? The new rule for this is new first row is equal to old first row minus key element into new second row. This is the rule that we have here. Fine. This is the rule that we have here. What is the rule? New first row is equal to old first row minus key into new second row. So this is how we are going to calculate the new first row elements. This is the rule for that. Now see here, if we see the first one, if we see the first one, how do we calculate the first one? As the formula is here only, so we will see how are we going to calculate it. So is equal to old first row values. Now if you see the old first row values, 3, 2, 1, 1, right? So we are going to take one by one, 3, fine, 3, old first row. The old first row first element is 3, minus, what is the key element here? The key element here is 2, 2, into, what is the new first, new second row? New second row value is 1, the first one, so 1 here. So how much it is? It is now 3, minus 2 is equal to 1. So we are going to write down here 1. Fine. So we are going to write down here 1. So this is how we are going to calculate it. This is the first one. So we are going to write down here 1. Then we have second one. Second one is equal to second element. What is the old first row? Old first row is now 2 minus, what is the key element? It is 2. The key element is 2 into new first row is 1 by 2. New first row is 1 divided by 2. Fine. Is equal to, this is 2 minus 2 divided by 2. 2 minus 2 divided by 2 is 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. Fine. So we are going to get here now 1. We are going to get here 1. So write down 1 here. Then again, next one we are going to calculate is old first row element. Old first row element here is now for x3 it is 1. So write down is equal to 1 minus key is 2. Key element is 2 into 1 minus 1 minus 2 into 1. Fine. So is equal to how much it is now? 1 minus 2 is equal to minus 1. So we are going to get minus 1 here, where we are going to get minus 1 here. Fine. So write down minus 1 here. Minus 1. So x3 is minus 1. Then we have to calculate SI value. This S, what is the value for this? For the new first row. It is equal to here. What we have to calculate? S1. So take down here 1 minus 2 is the key element into 0. So what we are going to get here is, we are going to get here is 1. So 1 is the value that we are going to put here. So this is 1 here. Now the last one here is to calculate the BI value. BI value we have here, what is that? Old first row is how much? It is 3. Fine. So take down 3 minus 2 into 1. 1 is the new element here, which is here, that we have already calculated from the first row. So we are going to get here is 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. Fine. So 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So write down here 1. Fine. So these are the all elements that we have calculated for the row 1, that is the new first row. After that, we are going to calculate the Zrj values, and after Zrj is what we are calculating. We are calculating Zrj minus Cj values. Fine. So Zrj minus Cj values we are going to calculate. Now Zrj here is, it is this, the Cj value and the coefficient of this. 0 into 1 is 0 plus 3 into 1 is 3. Fine. 3 into 1 is 3. Then we are going to multiply this. 0 into 1 is 0 plus 3 into 1 by 2 is 3 by 2. Fine. 3 by 2. 3 by 2. And then we have this. 0 into minus 1 is 0 plus 3 into 1 is 3. So we are going to get 3 here. And then we have 0 into 1 is 0 plus 3 into 0 is 0. But here we have to add all these xi and cj values of all x1, x2, x3, s1. So the value here is 1. Here again it is 1. Here it is 3. And here it is 0. Fine. Now Zrj minus Cj. This value minus this. 3 minus 1 is how much? 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 by 2 minus 1. 3 by 2 minus 1 is 3 minus 2 divided by 2. Right? So 3 minus 2 is 1. That is 1 by 2. So we are going to write down here 1 divided by 2. Fine. Here 3 minus 3 is 0 and 0 minus 0 is 0. Now if we see here, all our Zrj minus Cj values are greater than or equal to 0, because 2, 1 by 2, 0 and 0, they are all either greater than equal to 0 or greater than 0, and hence we say in the iterations second, the solution is optimal. And here if we see here, we have s1 and x3. So here we are taking s1, and the value for s1 is how much? 1. Fine. And the value for s1 is 1. Then we have x3, and the value for x3 is how much? It is 1. So both have same values. Both have same values. If we see here, that is s1 is 1 and x3 is 1. So what we are going to do, we are going to put same values here in the first maximization case. So what we are going to do, we are going to put the value of s1 and x3, only these two we are going to take. Fine. Now we have here max z is equal to x1. What is the value of x1? There is no x1. Fine, it is 0. Plus, what is the value of x2? Do we have x2 here? No, it is again 0. Plus 3x3, what is the value of x3? x3 is 1. 3 into x3, what is the value? It is 1. 3 into 1 is 3. Plus, we have s2, what is the value of, s1, what is the value for s1? S1 is 1. So 0 into 1 is again 0. 0 into 1 is again 0. Plus, is there any value for s2? No. And hence again 0. So the total value of the max z here is, and hence max z is equal to 3. So this is the answer for this LPP by simplex method. Thank you so much for watching. Please do subscribe, like my videos and share it with all your friends. Thank you so much.